Good evening. I'm Erica McManus, and this is a breaking Fox News report. It's just past 11 p.m. in London, where a massive police presence seeks to prevent the fourth straight night of rioting. Senior Foreign Affairs correspondent Amy Kellogg tells us if these preparations have been effective.
The key negotiators are all headed to the White House tomorrow morning. The top Democrats and Republicans in the House and the Senate will try to start breaking this impasse. They're stuck over taxes. Republicans say they refuse to sign off on any tax increases. They say that'll stunt the already disappointing economic growth. Democrats want to increase them for wealthier Americans, oil companies, and hedge fund managers.
One of the big surprises in yesterday's House vote, Representative Gabrielle Giffords, who was shot in the head by a gunman back in January, joined her colleagues to cast her vote. They cheered her, applauded her, even stood on chairs in the chamber. She's been in rehabilitation since the shooting. Good evening, I'm Erica McManus. This is a Fox News alert. Nervous investors who spent the weekend stewing over a late Friday downgrade of the nation's credit rating ran for the exits today. From the opening bell to the closing one. The Dow Jones Industrial Average finished down 635 points to fall below 11,000. The S&P 500 lost 80 and NASDAQ plummeted 175. We have Fox team coverage. Liz Klayman puts this sell-off in perspective right from the floor of the New York Stock Exchange. Ed Henry reports on what the president is saying at the White House. But first, we'll begin with Fox Business Network correspondent Rich Edson with how this stock slide is playing both here and around the world. More signals and reports pointing to weakening economic growth are weighing on markets. This afternoon, the Federal Reserve reported economic growth earlier this summer has continued to slow. Investors are also concerned about the debt debate. Even if Washington raises the debt limit the next week, analysts are questioning this country's credit rating. Top agencies rate the United States government debt as a AAA investment. That means the U.S. has an extremely strong ability to pay back lenders with interest. Through with high government debt, rating firms have warned the U.S. to cut the deficits to keep its AAA rating. For Fox Business News, I'm Erica McManus.